In this video, we're gonna do something fun. I'm gonna use this spinning wheel to help me decide what I should be designing on a t-shirt. Let's go. Thanks for joining me on this video. My name is Juno with Detour Shirts. I've been designing and selling t-shirts online since 2005, and I wanna give you some techniques and ideas on what to do if you're stuck designing t-shirts. So you may have run into a roadblock, or that happens all the time, and you need some ideas to generate some ideas. So this is an idea that I thought of that would be fun as well, and that is to use a spinning wheel to help you decide what to design. So I'm gonna go to spinningwheel.com and I'll show you what I'm talking about. So here I am on spinnerwheel.com. You can just make your own. I went on Redbubble and tried to find like what are the things that people love to buy the most. So we got space in here. I got space twice. Let me edit this. Space. That is good. Now I need another word. Let's try. So you can see this is how it works. You can just add in different words. You know, I love ramen. So let's, I don't think ramen is in here. Is it in here? No, hopefully I don't put ramen in twice. And then do ramen. There we go. So you can see I can add all kinds of different things, sushi, records, skeletons, bunch of things that I know that are popular. And then we're just gonna let the wheel spin and help us decide what it is. So I'm gonna hide these results here, like that. And let's give it a spin. Here we go, this is exciting. Let's see what we're gonna make a t-shirt about. And it is about a sloth. So sloths are really good, and there's tons of sloth things out there. But what we're gonna do is take it one step further. We're gonna do a mashup. So because we don't wanna make it the same as everybody else, we're gonna try and mash it up with something else and be something super original, right? So let's close this. Sloth is first. Second one, let's spin it again. Sloth and coffee. Those should work really well. I think I can figure out something with a sloth and coffee, and this will be great. This can be a good sticker. It doesn't have to have any words. This is just a way for you to get your creative juices flowing, and you can hit this as many times as you want. If you don't like those two to begin with, hit it again. I'm just gonna do it this way, sloth and coffee, and of course I can do this every time I get stuck or something. This is really helpful to kind of get your brain thinking of what two things to mash together, and you already have popular items on here. Hopefully you found things that are popular. Sloths are popular, coffee's popular. So we're gonna mash the two together, and hopefully people who love sloths and people who love coffee will like this design if it's designed well. So I'm gonna, next step is I'm gonna get a pencil and paper and jot down some ideas on what I could do with coffee and sloth. So after getting coffee and sloth, the next thing you would wanna do after you getting your two words, you're gonna wanna draw some ideas. So I took a pencil and paper, I drew some ideas like this, and take those ideas, they can be just really simple sketches, and then pick one of those. I usually do about six of them, six to nine of them, and then I try and figure out which one I like the best, which layout is the best, which way I want the sloth to hold the coffee in this case, or what they are doing. There's so many different ways that you can do it. And you can look online for inspiration, but don't copy anybody on there. Actually, there were a lot of sloth and coffees, so I had to think of something that I didn't see on there. That's one thing you wanna do, so to make yours original. Once you decide what you wanna do, you can take your design and then do pencil and paper and draw it just a little bit better. It doesn't have to be perfect, but bigger and a little more detailed than your little sketch there, and then bring it into Affinity Designer. So you don't have to use a pencil and paper, you can use your tablet. I just chose not to do a tablet in this case so that I can show you how to do it on Affinity Designer and some techniques I use this way. But one advantage of using a tablet is it's already digital, so you don't have to scan it and trace it again. So pros and cons, if you are used to drawing on paper and pencil, then you might wanna do this way. If you're more familiar with doing the tablet, then do it that way. So here we are in Affinity Designer. You can use any program you want, but I use Affinity Designer. There's a sale on Affinity Designer, by the way, right now, if depending on when you watch this video, but I think it's 50% off right now. So if you're watching it as this video is live or within the couple weeks of this video, I think it'll still be on. So go to Affinity Designer or serif.com. Anyway, you can use Illustrator, Inkscape, GIMP, whatever you want. So I just scanned in my sketches. So you can see this sketch right here is what I did, the quick sketch. Like I told you, I got six designs here, the sloth in the cup, holding a cup, you know, front facing on top of the cup. I decided I like sloths just lying on the branch. I see that a lot, but I haven't seen one where he's holding up a cup like this. So that's what I'm gonna do. I've seen a bunch of these other ones. I wanted to do something more original, so this is what I did. And then of course, being even more original, I drew my own. So this is something you're gonna wanna do to make sure that yours is super original if you have some artistic talent, or even if you think you don't, draw in your own style. Redbubble, you'll see so many different styles on Redbubble if you're designing for Redbubble, and they love artistic work. Even if the simplest drawings sell on Redbubble, just take a look at some really simple sloths on there too. So here's just a simple version of my sloth holding a coffee cup right here. So once you have your design, your drawn design, it can be as detailed as you want or as simple as you want. Depending on how detailed it is, it could take you longer to trace it. My total time doing this took me about 2 hours, 3 hours. So it does take a while to do this process. And again, you would save some time if you already drew it digitally on your tablet, because you would have it and then you can just export it. But what you would have to do next is to trace this. So I'll show you how to do it. This is it being traced right here. It's real easy. All you have to do is come in here. I'll zoom in, get my pen tool right here, and then click on the lines, right? And then just drag. And you may want your stroke to be a different size. So come in here, hit stroke and color. If you don't see a stroke, you might not have a color on here. You can see this stroke doesn't have a color. Turn it on and you can change the size of your stroke, bigger or smaller, depending on what you like. In this example, I'm using 8.5. You don't wanna go too thin. Well, you don't actually need an outline sometimes. It can just be the fill, right? So depending on what you want, you may want to outline, you may not. I'm going to use an outline in mine just so you can see it. So that's how you do it. You do this around the whole thing, and you can see I did that here already. It took me a little while to do that. And then after that step, the next step you want to do is to fill it in. So I'm just filling in the colors here, and you can see I still have the stroke right here, but the color is behind it, which I filled in. So real easy to do. And then just pick the colors that you want. So go online, find out what color a sloth is, or what color, you know, a coffee cup is, and things like that. And then start playing with colors. I tried to use all kinds of browns here. So you can see I got lighter and darker browns here. But you can use whatever color you want. In fact, if you change this to like a different color, it actually might stand out. So if you do something that's not a wood color, right? Like, let's say, wood's not this color, but it may stand out and maybe people like it, right? So you could come in here and change the color like that. And in fact, that contrast is really nice too. So play around with color. This could take a little while. Just find the colors that you like the best. And then the next step that I do here is I was thinking about where to put text. So we know on t-shirt designs, you wanna make it a tall rectangle. And so I'm thinking about putting the sloth on the bottom and then have some text on the top here. And one thing that I thought would be fun is to play with this curve here. So you see this curve that I made with the sloth having his butt up like that is this curve. So I can play with that with the text. And let me show you what I'm talking about. So right here, I'm using this font and it's called Watermelon. You can use whatever font you want. And then this font right here is Good Dog Plain. And the reason I'm using these fonts is because they're easy to manipulate. And when you do, it doesn't look too off. Let me show you what I mean. So I'm gonna go in here, click on here and hit convert to curves. And now I can ungroup these and start messing with coffee. So I can put this down here, you know, maybe make this bigger like this. And then I can double click on it and move it to the lines to make it the right shape. So I'm gonna zoom in just a little bit more so you can see what I mean. Grab these points and move them. There's not a real cool way, easy way to do this, that wave look, right, that you do on Kittle. This is the way you would do it on Affinity Designer, is you kind of would grab the points and move it down. And you know, you can move this one too, same thing, move it down. So I did that with all of the letters, and this is what happened when I did it. So you can see I followed that right here. So this takes a little while, but all you do is grab the points and match it. And I did the same thing right here. And I changed the wording a little bit. This one says, a little slothy, I just need some coffee. And I have that tall rectangle now. And it works great on white. And I use some of that same lines on the coffee because we're talking about coffee here. So you can see kind of, this is just a technique to kind of make it stand out, right? So I like how it turned out. I use the same colors. I use the black because I use the black outline. You don't have to use a black outline. And then I use this color, which is the same color as this, the body color. Now, the next thing you want to do is put it on a black t-shirt. So I change the background to black and then the letters to white just so it stands out and so it's easy to stand out on some other colors. So if I had red as the background right here, it still works with the white, right? And I took out the lines here on the coffee just so it stands out better. You never know what color you're going to get. On white, you kind of do, but on the dark colors, you don't. So I took that out. And then I changed the color on the branch, right? Just to make it stand out better on some darker colors. So that's how it looks like on black. And then the nice thing, whoops, I don't want that. Undo, I want the background black. All right, so that's what it looks like on a black t-shirt and gray and all the other colors. You can play around with the background colors, right? So the next thing I wanted to do is think about stickers. So since you already have some art here, you might want to think about making these stickers on Redbubble. When you go on Redbubble and you look at stickers, you might notice that a lot of them are just pictures. So think about that when you're doing this. And so just play with it. Give yourself some time to think about what you can do with this picture that you just made, this custom design that you made. You can use it not only for t-shirts, but use it for stickers. So here's one idea that I did. Just the design, right? I think it would do really well because it tells a story already. It's a sloth holding a coffee, right? Everybody gets the idea. He's sleepy, he needs coffee. Coffee's gonna help. The next thing, maybe add a little bit of words. So I use that coffee right here and change the words to say, I just need coffee. And this could make a nice sticker as well. And by playing around with this, you can generate more and more ideas. Here's another idea, my last idea. And this is the one I ended up doing. I notice that this has a heart shape because this is up here and this is up here and they're coming down to a point. So it looks like a heart. And sometimes you find these nice things that happen just accidentally, coincidentally. And so this worked and I'm gonna put this on Redbubble and I'll show you what it looks like on Redbubble on stickers and things like that. So here I am on Redbubble. I named mine Sloth Loves Coffee Heart and I edited it right now. I think I'm going to put Cute Sloth Loves Coffee Heart. And here are some tags. I just found these tags on Redbubble when you search for coffee or sloth, you know, just real simple like that. And then a description, just write a description of what it is. Maybe it's in a heart. So maybe put like this, cute sloth is in a heart, like that. So then I put it on different shirts. You can see here, just come in here and you can move them around and pick the different colors. It works on some colors, but I think it will work on all of them actually with the black outline and everything. So that's a great design. I put it on stuff that works. The cap didn't work that well. So let me show you what I mean. So it gets kind of cut off. And then when I get it too small, you know, maybe that works. I can leave it, but there's some things that don't work. Well, I don't like it on the all over prints. You can see it makes a really good sticker though. So I'm hoping that this will do well on sticker. It's an original artwork that I did. It's a drawing. This is what an artist would do. And this is kind of what Redbubble would, I think would promote is original art, right? And it's a mashup of two things. So I'm getting the sloth people and getting the coffee people to look at this stuff. So. And I put a background on it. You can pick any background you want. I put a red background to match the heart. And let's see, I put it on a bunch of things, but some of them I didn't. Just make sure that you put them on things that make sense and that fit. So pick and choose, but put them on multiple. Don't just put it on t-shirts. So you can see I have a bunch of these. It works good on the tote bag and everything, aprons. And when you're done, just hit I have the rights to do this and save your work, and that's it. You may have to do different sizes on postcards and things just to make sure that it works on the postcards. You don't want that white outline. At least I don't want that white outline on the top and the bottom. I'll show you what I mean when I go down to postcards. You can see the postcards don't have it because I saved a separate file that's the right size. So have fun with this. This is a great technique to do. Use that spinning wheel and find two ideas and mash them together. So that is it for this video. Hopefully this video is very fun and educational for you. You can learn some of the techniques that I use personally. Again, it takes a long time to do, but I think the result pays for itself because it's an original artwork, two things getting mashed up. So you're getting, you know, in my case, the people who love sloth and the people who love coffee and putting that together. So more people are interested in it. That's a great way to do it. I'm also gonna leave a link to the wheel. If you wanna use that wheel or make your own wheel, I'll leave a link in the bottom to do it. Hopefully this video is really helpful for you. If it was, make sure to give it a thumbs up. And if you're not subscribed to this channel already, hit that subscribe button right there. The question of the day for this video is, if you use that wheel, what are the two things that you ended up with? I would love to hear it in the comments. Leave that below. And if you wanna see more design videos on my channel, click on these videos right here. And as always, guys, keep creating and keep learning. I'll see you on the next one. Bye.